Well, independent film is how I first fell in love with movies, and every film I've ever made has been an independent film. So for me, it's extremely important that it keeps going. They make films from a place of love and passion and vision, rather than from, you know, necessarily a commercial upside from the beginning. And independent films, where films for grown-ups are being made at the moment, because the studios are kind of taking care of the teen market and the sort of merchandising market. Independent film is where short-form storytelling is surviving for grown-ups. So, you know, and that's me. I hope to be a grown-up one day. Well, I mean, I've just written a film, and I hope to produce and direct it. And it's festivals like this that are the lifeblood of people like me, who are trying to express themselves, maybe for the first time, trying to find an audience, trying to find, you know. And festivals have a ready-made audience who are there to consume your product. And of course, independent film doesn't have the big, you know, marketing strategic budgets to plaster billboards everywhere. So we have to find an audience, and they live and breathe in festivals like this.
Recently, you had, an attempted reunion with the Battlestar cast. It didn't quite go to plan, but can you talk a little bit about how it felt to be at least remotely involved in that experience?
Well, it's a funny thing because, there was a reunion in Texas, and I was in France where I live, and I couldn't get there because it was my daughter's birthday, so I tried to Skype in the middle of the night, and it didn't quite work, although I did get a huge cheer for loads of people that I couldn't see, and I was on my little laptop whilst my daughter was having a sleepover in the garden with tents. So it was a bizarre experience. But the honest truth is, Battlestar reunions happen all the time because we're all still great friends. So we actually get together quite a lot. It's rare that we can all be there with the fans. And that was special. But there are a few more events planned. I don't know what's in the air, but people seem to want to get the Battlestar crew together and celebrate what we did all those years ago now, yeah.
In terms of other things that are coming up for you, I know you've been working with Claire Forlani, I think, Crystal Inferno. Can you talk a little bit about that?
I did a film with Claire a year ago in Bulgaria, which is being sold at the moment. Sort of a take on the Towering Inferno, which was cool. And then I've done another film in Bulgaria, actually, called The Car, another remake of a 70s Universal product. So we'll see how that goes. And then I'm doing Marcella, the second season of Marcella for ITV and Netflix and the rest of the world at the moment. Busy. And trying to get this film off the ground that I've written as well.
It's an homage to one of the classic disaster flicks. Can you talk a little bit about what excited you about that kind of cinema?
Well, this is really a film about human relationships. It's about a couple who are in the middle of a divorce, and they're on the umpteenth floor in some big glass building settling their divorce. Unbeknownst to them, their kids have actually followed them into the building, and then a huge great fire breaks out because of some rather unscrupulous sort of capitalist decisions to try and make this building on the cheap. And it's a film, it's a very human film about, you know, two people through adversity trying to save their children, and actually connecting with each other for the first time in a while.
The next season of Marcella, obviously a lot of fans around the world waiting for that one. Can you talk a little bit about what overall you think fans can expect from the next season when we do get it?
Well, we've got Hans Rosenfeld writing for us, and he is the black belt of Scandi Noir. So he's pulled out all the stops again. A big cast, lots of questions, lots of red herrings, wondering, you know, the audience has to piece together what's going on. Anna Friel's back in the title role, and I'm back, and Nick Pinnock is back, and it's a wonderful story that Hans has written, again set in London. Lots of sort of social issues of the time, lots of retrospective sort of sex cases like we've seen in the papers in the last few years, some zero hour labor hiring sort of intrigue. It's very much about our city today, but it's also quite an extreme and quite dark plot about an abducted boy who happens to be a school friend of Marcella's son. She never gets it easy, poor old Marcella, and she's put through the ringer again with her fugues and her blackouts and everything else.
What do you think is so special about what Anna has done with that character?
But she just brings a real, an honesty, a fragility. It's an incredibly challenging role to play, someone who is really sort of questioning her own reality, who's being tortured on all fronts by the men in her life, by the workplace, by just about everything that Hans Rosenfeld can think of to throw at her. So Anna's always going through the ringer, and you know, it takes an incredible amount of emotional and physical energy to do that. And she's on set every day, all day, for 5.5 months at a shot. So yeah, she's the glue that really makes the show work, and we're lucky to have her.